there is a system of avoiding tissue damage in most kinds of animals. So there's some degree of avoidance of damage to the body in even the simplest animals. So they move away from things which are harmful. But that is usually a fairly rapid response without any great necessity for having long-term consequences. So that's the simplest situation. But then the pain system, pain as we describe it in ourselves, involves a sensation and then transmission to the brain, and the brain is analyzing it in quite a complex way, taking account of lots of other information. And so pain involves a high-level brain response as well as the immediate local tissue, local sensory receptor response. So if we look at pain systems in other species, then we at the current thinking is that all vertebrates, so mammals, birds, reptiles, fish, amphibians, they all have a fully functional pain system with the high-level brain functioning, which is needed in order to learn from negative experiences. So far, the invertebrate animals where this has been demonstrated are the cephalopod mollusks, which is octopus, squid, cuttlefish, and the decapod crustacea, so crabs, lobsters, prawns. There's good evidence for full, proper pain systems in those animals. In other animals, like insects, snails, flatworms, and so on, so far we haven't quite got enough information to say that they've got a fully functional pain system. So I'd say the answer is all vertebrate animals and the cephalopods and those crustacea, the decapod crustacea. They're the ones, but there may be others, and we may find out more. We have found out more in the last 20 years, and we've added animals in that time. We may add some more in the future.